Sea ice in the Antarctic likely reached its annual peak this month, and that peak is lower than any other on record in that region.
Meteorologist Heather Waldman spoke with a climate scientist for some context.
On September 10th, satellites showed that ice was covering just over 6.5 million square miles of ocean around Antarctica. That was likely the annual peak now that it's spring in the Southern Hemisphere. The National Snow and Ice Data Center says that this year's peak ice cover is the lowest on record, with records dating back to 1979. That's nearly 400,000 square miles less than the previous record, which was set back in 1986. Dr. Zachary Labe is a climate scientist with NOAA and Princeton University. He says decreasing ice near the South Pole is a relatively new trend.
For sea ice levels, we've actually saw up until about 2015, we saw a no trend or maybe a slightly increasing trend in sea ice. But since 2016 or so, we've seen a dramatic change. And that's where all scientists are wondering what's going on down there.
Now contrast that with Arctic sea ice, which NASA says has been decreasing by an average of 12.5% each decade for the past 40 years. Scientists can directly connect this with climate change resulting from our carbon emissions. Temperatures in the Arctic are rising 3 to 4 times faster than anywhere else on Earth. Climate change is likely a part of what's going on in the Antarctic, but the weight of that fingerprint is a lot less clear. There's also a huge geographical difference between the two poles. The Arctic is ocean surrounded by land, while the Antarctic is land surrounded by ocean. Because of that, there's more year-to-year variability in Antarctic ice cover. Labe says the connection to carbon emissions is worth exploring because the polar regions help to balance the planet's temperature.
So if you start warming these regions, removing snow cover and the amount of sea ice, that's going to warm these areas, which then warms the rest of the globe.
And this is a look at Arctic sea ice trends. It's now starting to slowly increase ahead of Northern Hemisphere winter that typically peaks in March.